You know, among the First Nation, they are very, they have a, something they call protocol. When you meet somebody for the first time, you are to present gift to them. And so we, that day, that's why we started on the 6th, and there were about 150 people, and we just honor one another.
那么还有一件事情呢，这个整个是连在一起，很好玩的，就是说，有一位呢，就是聚会之前的两天，他才说他要来，然后他也没有经费。
And you know, just before we had this meeting, only 2 days before that, one of the First Nation leader he called and said that he felt he should be in this meeting, but he doesn't have enough money.
那么是别人跟他联络的，所以跟我打电话，我想说这个不能用公家的钱，这个呢我可以帮助，我说我给你几百块，我给他几百块。And
so you know, it was through another person that he expressed his desire to come, and I felt like I should maybe personally support him a couple hundred dollars.
所以我就答应那个跟我讲的那个。
So I say, okay, you know, you can come.
结果那一天呢，我们有个节目是请那个犹太拉比来点灯，因为这个礼拜呢是这个光明节，然后要点那个犹太的油灯。And
that day we need to, because it's Hanukkah, so you know, in the Hanukkah they light the candles, menorah.
那我正好在那个时刻呢。 我就看到那个姊妹呢，我就要拿钱给她，我就走到她面前。And
when I saw the sister, and that you know that, so I went to her in order to give her the money because she paid first.
所以我拿钱给她的时候，她说：“糟糕，现在马上要点那个灯了，没有火柴。”And
then she told me, you know, I cannot find the candle now. It's time.
Match.
The match. Now I have to light, you know, the rabbi needs to light the candle. And so she was kind of looking for the match.
所以正在紧张，她跟我讲这个说，我说我有火柴。
And she was quite nervous, and I told her, oh, I know, I have some match in my bag.
我就到我的皮包里头呢，拿一个火柴给她。
So I took a match and I gave it to her.
然后呢，这个 rabbi 就点灯。
And the rabbi was able to use the match to light up the menorah.
完了以后，有人问我说：“你抽烟吗？”
And so someone asked me, "Do you smoke?"
我说我没有抽烟。
No, I don't.
就几天前呢，突然有个念头呢，觉得要带一个火柴，就是 in case 万一有人需要的话，我包包里头有火柴。
A thought came to me a couple of days before, you know, to put a match in my bag. And just in case someone needs it.
而且我从来根本没有放火柴在我的包包里头。
I never did that before.
结果你们知道为什么我放火柴吗？
Do you know why I put the match?
有人有印象吗？
Do you remember?
12月1号礼拜六我们有 healing room 在这里对吗？
Remember we had a healing room on December the 1st in this near the church.
然后他们说要 点这个生日的蛋糕，
and so someone had a birthday and they want to light a candle.
就是12岁的 Peyton 生日， 16岁的 Peyton 生日。
It was Peyton's 16th birthday.
然后那天我还有一张照片， Peyton 呢，这个蛋糕拿在手上，然后他弟弟也伸手要摸那个蜡烛的点都着。
And I still have the picture, you know, that he holding this birthday cake, but they were trying to light the candle, but somehow cannot get it, you know.
所以后来他们说，我们到那个 fellowship hall 去点吧。
So then we moved to the fellowship hall.
然后我们也在那里吃蛋糕。
And so we had the cake over there.
所以有一天我就想到说，万一有人需要，所以我应该放。
So that kind of reminds me, maybe I should keep a match in my bag.
所以那是礼拜四发生的奇妙的事情。
And that was kind of like a miracle that happened on last Thursday.
然后聚会结束以后，礼拜一呢，我跟那个 Peter Smith 还有几个人， 我们到费城去。
And then after the meeting, this past Monday, Peter Smith and a few of us, we visited Philadelphia.
因为那个原住民还没有回去，我想应该是陪他们。
Because many First Nations still stay behind, and so I felt like I want to spend more time with them.
我们去参观一个最老的这个犹太会堂。
And we were, you know, in while there, we visited one of the oldest synagogue in Philadelphia.
是从1740年一直到现在都有人聚会的。
That is not the oldest one, but it's the one that continuously meeting since 1740 something until now.
然后看见前面有一个点油的这个一个架子，一个灯的架子。
And I saw they have a special place that have some that place some oil.
那么底下有一大罐的油。
And then underneath is a lot of oil.
那上面有个火柴盒，底下也有火柴盒。
And then they have two matches, one on the top.
在上面的是新的、干净的，底下那个泡在油里头。
One on the top is still a new, it's you know, but the other one in the bottom, it was kind of soaked in the oil.
所以我就拿了一份，叫那个管理的那个太太，我说我跟你讲一个见证。有个 rabbi 上个礼拜四要点灯，然后我怎么，哇！我说今天我又看到这里有一个火柴，这个我可以留作纪念，好吧？因为这里也是犹太会堂，所以我说神真的在做事。
So I talked to the secretary and I explained to her the miracle. Then I say, you know, this, I'm surprised to find a match here. Can I have this one?
她很高兴，她替我高兴，说好，你可以。
She was very happy. She said, "Oh yes, yes, you can keep this one."
所以我家里有三个火柴。
So I have three matches.
因为那个 Mary Allen 呢找不到火柴，第二天晚上呢，她才找到，是一个全新的火柴，放在她包包里了。就是那个时候怎么找不到，后来她找到了，送给我。
There's one that belonged to Mary Allen. That was the one that she put in the purse, but couldn't find, so she gave it to me.
所以啊，这个故事你们听懂吗？
So do you understand the story?
听得懂吗
？You understand it? Okay, good.
就是说这个神做事情是很有意思的，是 everything 是串在一起的。
What I'm saying is that you know God is very, the way he operate, you know, he makes sure everything is connected.
那天生日。火点不着，你看这个都有意义的，都有用处的。
Yeah, even that day, we couldn't light the birthday candle, but because of that, it reminds me of keeping one in my bag.
然后我有心要奉献给一个原住民，就是那个时刻，这不早不给他，晚不给，我就那个时刻，我拿到前面去给那个 Mary Ellen.
And then because I have thea burden to support this First Nation, and it was at that moment kind of I saw you know the lady, so I wanted to give her the money, and that's when she couldn't find the matches.
所以在整个的事情背后，上帝在牵针穿针引线，上帝在连接。
So you know behind the scene, you can see how the Lord prepare everything.
好。这个是一个见证，今天这个不是我主要讲的。
This is just a testimony.
我主要讲的是做门徒的代价。
The message I want to share is about the cost of discipleship.
这个我其实不久以前讲过。
I have shared this before.
但是我觉得非常重要。
Because it's so important, I wanted to share again.
但是分享这个之前呢，我先跟大家讲利未记。
But before we go there, I just want to give a review of the book of Leviticus.
利未记是非常丰富的。
It's a very rich book.
利未记告诉我们怎么样做神，怎么样跟神建立关系。
Because it really teaches how to establish relationship with God.
做神的家里人。
How to become a family member.
所以认真的圣经的学生呢，又懂得神的爱的话，你读利未记会很受感动的。
If you're a serious student of the Bible and you also under God's love, when you read that book, you will be so touched.
有许多宝贵的教训，我在这里复习一下。
And there are many, many precious truths, and I will review just remind you again.
利未记里头是神直接说话。
In this book, God talked to us directly.
而且讲到神家里头的规矩。
And he teaches about the rule in his household.
利未记是讲神的爱。
And he talks about his love.
我以前不懂，所以以前不念，现在念。
In the past, I didn't pay too much attention because I didn't understand. Now I love to read this book.
所以我已经讲过几次，犹太人孩子第一本书要念的就是利未记。
I have mentioned before that the first book every Jewish child read is the book of Leviticus.
它里面一直出现的一个字，上个礼拜我有讲说是50次以上，他就说。因为我是圣洁的神，我是耶和华你们的神。
And there's at least repeated 50 times. It talks about I'm a holy God, is your God.
那么我以前讲过好几次，以前我觉得这一句话是很大声说的，但是我发觉不是，它是很小声说的。
In the past, I thought, oh, God said it kind of with anger and but not later I realized he was just very soft.
他说我是圣洁的，所以你们要圣洁。
And he just said, I am holy, therefore you need to be holy.
所以利未记是告诉我们怎么样来到这位圣洁的神的面前，可以享受他的福分。
So this book actually is talking about how can we approach him so that and establish a relationship so we can enjoy the blessings.
所以利未记呢是，其实是写给那些愿意在成为他的家人，然后愿意长大成熟的孩子所写的。
So this book is written for those people who really wanted to mature and to follow him.
Yeah, 所以我也提到说，读神的话要很小心的读。
Therefore, we need to read it carefully.
要懂上帝的心意，不要随便来。
And then we need to read, and as we read it, we have to understand his heart.
不要像那个拿达亚比户随便照自己的心意。
And do not follow like Nada or Abihu, and they don't care. They just do whatever their heart desires.
所以有关神的话语，如果我们不懂的，就是你暂时不要改变它，你有一天总是会懂的，圣灵会教导你。
Sometimes you come across certain Bible verses that you don't understand. Don't reject it. You know, just keep it there, and one day the Holy Spirit will teach you.
如果我们做错的话，有圣这个良心责备我们，赶快跪下来跟神认罪祷告，因为神是圣洁。
When we sin or make mistake, and you know when the Holy Spirit convicted you, immediately kneel down and repent before the Lord.
不要任凭自己。
Don't just say, well.You know, I just follow the flesh.
如果我们任凭自己的话，圣灵不与我们同在，我们有可能像巴兰啊，像参孙啊，这样下场不好。
If a person always kind of just follow their flesh, and to the point that God would just kind of put you aside, like Balaam or Samson.
请问新约圣经哪一卷书跟利未记可以相呼应的？
And do you know which book in the New Testament actually is very comparable to the book of Leviticus?
James. 希伯来书。
Actually, it's Hebrew.
那请问有人讲说希伯来书跟利未记是双生子。
Some people call them are twins.
那请问哪一个是弟弟，哪一个是哥哥
？Which one is the older brother and the young? Which one is the young one?
利未记是弟弟。
弟弟。Leviticus is a younger brother.
然后希伯来书是哥哥。
And Hebrew actually is the elder son.
因为长大了嘛。
Because he's mature.
而且讲 discipline, 讲被管教，讲的
he talks about,
比利未记还更多。
He talks about that, you know, God discipline his children.
但是希伯来书不取代利未记，为什么呢？因为主耶稣说我来是要成全律法。
But Hebrew cannot replace the book of Leviticus because Jesus said, "I come not to abolish, but to fulfill the law."
整个的新约圣经里头告诉我们说，神要的 不是律法，不是仪式，乃是我们的心。
And the whole Bible tells us what God is after is not the law, but our heart.
是我们的生命。
It's our life.
而且圣经里头告诉我们说，不要像文士法律赛人，守外面的东西，但是心不对，而错过神的祝福。
And the Bible also said that do not be just like the Pharisee and the scribes. They focus on the outside, but their heart is not right.
我想这个呢一定要谨慎，要注意。这个包括我们许多做礼拜的基督徒跟尤其牧师长子。
And this is applied to every one of us, including the pastors and the regular church attenders.
我们现在来看路加福音十四章。
Let's turn to Luke 14.
路加福音十四章。
14.
我在 line 里头讲说，我们这一次我们也不用那个 PowerPoint， 我们就是来看圣经。
So let's read our Bible.
我们来看路加福音第十四章的第一节到第三节。
Let's first read Verse 1 to 3.
然后我就问大家说，在这里耶稣在跟什么人说话？
And then I will ask you a question. Who is Jesus talking to?
在这里耶稣跟什么人说话？
Do you know? Yeah, Pharisee.
法利赛人。
Jesus was talking to the Pharisee.
然后第十二节开始。
And let's go to the 12, verse 12.
耶稣又对请他的人说，你摆设午饭或晚饭，不要请你的朋友、弟兄、亲属、邻舍，恐怕他们也请你，那么你就得了报答。你摆设筵席的时候，要请那些贫穷的、残废的、瘸腿的、瞎眼的，你就有福了。
Jesus said to his host, when you give a luncheon or dinner, do not invite your friends, your brothers or relatives, or your rich neighbors. If you do,They may invite you back, and so you will be repaid. But when you give a banquet, invite the poor, the crippled, the lame, and the blind.
所以今天我们关心原住民啊，关心这些受苦的啊，把爱给他们的话是讨神喜悦的。
So you know, like God, you know, what we are doing nowadays is to reach out and to bless the First Nation and the poor.
好，我们来看这个十五节到二十四节。
And let's read verse 15.
那么这里呢，主耶稣就讲一个大宴席的比喻。
Jesus then here talk about a big banquet.
这里大宴席的比喻呢，有他提到三个，就是那个这个主人呢要请大宴席的时候，就叫那个仆人去请别人来赴宴席。
When the host that wanted to have a great banquet, he sent his servant to invite the guests.
然后从十八节、十九节、二十节，你看到这些人呢，都去有很多的借口，他们不来。
Then if you read the verse 18, 19, and 20, the people who he were invited have many reason or excuses, and they didn't come.
我们来读十八节到二十节，我先用中文读，大家再用英文读哈。众人一起来读。众人一口同音的推辞，头一个说，我买了一块地，必须去看看，请你准我辞了。又有一个说，我买了五对牛，要去试一试，请你准我辞了。又有一个说，我才娶了妻，所以不能去。
So that, but they all alike began to make excuses. Let's read it, okay? The first said, I have just bought a field, and I must go and see it. Please excuse me. Another said,I have just bought 5 yoke of oxen, and I'm on my way to try them out. Please excuse me. Still another say, I just got married, so I cannot go. Come.
哎，奇怪，他们每一个人呢都有事情，但是别天不能做，就是主人请宴席的那一天，他需要忙。
You know, they all have things. I mean, they can do it the other day, but they just happen. You know, I can't do it because.I have to do this today.
所以啊，圣经里头二十一节，主人就动怒。
And the host was very angry.
然后就叫仆人到街小巷去把那贫穷的、残废的、 瘸腿的、瞎眼的，通通带进来。
So he just sent his servant to the street and alleys of the town, and then just bring the poor, the crippled, the blind, and the lame.
所以其实这些人呢，神所邀请的啊，他们就是找了 excuses.
Yeah. So the one that Jesus invited, I mean the host invited, they all give good excuses.
其实这些都是好事，但是偏偏必须那一天去忙。
You know, of course, what they, the reason they gave is okay, but they just felt like they have to do it that day.
啊，有一个刚刚结了婚，所以他也不赴约。啊，我想刚刚结婚是情有可原的，但是问题是神要爱神超过我们彼此地上的爱。
So even the one that just got married, so it kind of you know, makes sense. But even God said, you love the Lord more than, you know, anything else.
所以我在这里要把它做一个 很重要的归纳，就是说，我相信呢，这个神，我们不要用别的东西来找借口，然后不去回应神对我们的呼召，还有神的爱。
So I want to give a summary because I think it's important that we don't, you know, find excuses and not to respond to God's love.
包括侍奉。
Including ministry.
有的人说我探访都来不及了，哪里有时间去祷告？
Some people say, well, I'm so busy and I don't even have enough time to visit, to do visitation. I don't have time to for prayer.
而且我也相信在这里应用到我们很多人，就是说神所邀请我们的，我们不要因为贪爱世界继续在世界的里头然后去忽略神对我们的邀请。
And also, I just want to remind us that, you know, it's easy sometimes we are so focused on the world, and therefore when God wants us to do certain things, we say, oh, we can't.
好，那底下二十五节到三十四节呢，上帝就主耶稣就讲这个怎么样做门徒。
And then, from 25 on, Jesus start talking to them about how to become a disciple.
好，我们来看二十五节。
Okay, let's read verse 25.
预备，来，有极多的人和耶稣同行，他转过来对他们说：“人若到我这里来，若不爱我胜过爱自己的父母、妻子、儿女、弟兄姊妹和自己的性命，就不能做我的门徒。”凡不背着自己十字架跟从我的，也不能做我的门徒。
Large crowd were traveling with Jesus, and he turned to them and said, "If anyone come to me and does not hate his father and mother, his wife and children, his brother and sister, yes, even his own life, he cannot be my disciple. And anyone who does not carry his cross and follow me cannot be my disciple."
耶稣跟一般的牧师不一样。
You know, Jesus is so different from the regular pastors.
因为我们做牧师的，如果有很多人的话，我们就非常高兴。
Because as pastor, you want a big crowd to follow you.
但是你看看二十五节怎么讲。
But if you look at the verse 25,
有很多人跟耶稣同行。他就转过来，就叫别人走。
Many will follow Jesus, and Jesus turn around and tell them to kind of say, you know.
这个是很特别的事情。
And this is very special.
我以前听过这个 Francis Chan 讲过这个。
I have listened to Francis Chan, and he used this Bible verse.
他用很多的圣经节，然后每一次呢，有很多人跟着他的时候，耶稣就讲一些东西呢。叫别人走。
So he found that in the Bible there are many places when there, you know, Jesus had this happen. If there's a big crowd following him, he would say certain things and kind of to offend them, so they would leave.
好，我就举一个例子吧。我们请大家等等还要翻回来，请大家稍微看一下马太福音第八章。
Okay, let's turn to Matthew 8 and see what he said.
马太福音的第八章十八节。
And the verse 18.
你看十八节，马太福音十八章的第十八节。
Matthew 8:18.
有许多人围着他。
Many people surrounded him.
然后耶稣在二十节说，湖里有洞，天空的飞鸟有窝，人子没有枕头的地方。
And Jesus, in verse 20, he said, "Fox has holes and birds of air have nests, but the Son of Man has no place to lay his head."
然后二十二节说，任凭死人埋葬他们的死人，你跟从我吧。
And then 22 verse, he said, "Follow me and let the dead bury their own dead."
耶稣的意思就是说，你可以跟着大众敲锣打鼓呢，但是呢，你不见得能够做我的门徒。
I think what he meant is that you can follow the crowd and beat the drums, but you cannot be my true disciple.
这是很重的话。
And this is quite heavy.
我们回头看这个路加福音十四章。
And let's just go back to Luke 14.
那么二十六节吧。二十六节指的是什么
？26。
人若不原文作恨，人若不恨自己的父母、妻子、儿女、弟兄姐妹和自己的性命，就不能做我的门徒。
Yeah, if they don't, he used the word hate his father, mother, brothers, sisters.
有谁敢用这么重的字啊
？Who dare to use such a strong word.
但是耶稣不怕人误会。
But he's not afraid that people misunderstand him.
请问大家，恨父母，耶稣是不是叫你恨父母？
Is it here he's telling you that you should hate your parents?
绝对不是，对吗？
No.
十诫里头，前面四个诫是讲人跟神的关系，后面六个诫是讲人跟神，人跟人的关系，而人的跟人的关系呢，第一个就是讲要孝敬父母。
Because you all know that in Ten Commandments, the first four is talking about relation with God, and the rest of the six about relation with man. But then the first one on the commandment is the fifth is talking about honor your parents.
所以要敬重神，所以神不会矛盾的。
He's not a conflict.
我再问大家一个事情，约翰福音第六章我们现在不用翻，就是说耶稣讲说，吃我肉喝我血的人会因我而活着。
Yeah, remember in Book of John 6, he talks about those, if you eat my flesh and drink my blood, then you will live because of me.
那么耶稣，请问耶稣是讲真的吃他的肉喝他的血？
Jesus talking about really eating his flesh and drinking his blood?
一定不是。
It's not.
不是真的讲吃肉跟喝血。
It's not talking about that.
但是真正爱真理的人呢，他就不会误会。但是那个用自己头脑的人呢，就会跟神来争辩。
But if you truly love the truth, you will not be, you will not misunderstand what he's saying.But if you really are very rational and you know use your mind a lot, then maybe you will argue with God.
所以这个我们以前讲过了哈，那么大家已经明白了。
So I think you understand this point.
恨父母不是你我了解的恨父母。
So when he said hate your parents doesn't mean that literally hate them.
是爱神爱到一个地步太多。地上的爱，包括爱父母之间的爱呢，你没有字可以来形容，只能用恨这个字来对比。
And because you so love God to the point that you don't know what words to describe, so you use the hate as a contrast.
今天有很多恩典的神学。
Today I think you know there are many theology talk about grace.
我上回已经讲过了，但今天我要再提一下。
Even though I mentioned before, I really want to remind again.
请问救恩是神的礼物，是免费的，对吗？
Now, let me ask you, is salvation a gift from God and you just freely receive, right?
对吗？
Yes.
对哈。但是呢，他又要付生命的代价。
But then he also say you have to give your life.
信耶稣得永生这个事情呢，是 你要，但是你不能真正得到耶稣，除非你把你的生命摆下来。
You know, you believe in Jesus to receive eternal life. You have to lay down your life in order to receive His life.
我觉得这个都是太多圣经这样的，连那个有钱少年的官，我怎么样得永生？耶稣说你变卖一些，那他人就走了。
Yeah, remember the Bible have many examples, including the rich young ruler. When Jesus said, he asked Jesus, "How can I inherit the eternal life?" Jesus said, "Sell everything you own and you have, and then come follow me." And the young man, you know, just left.
所以我们很多人呢，就是逻辑想不通呢，我们就修改神的话语。
And so many people use another approach because their mind cannot understand, their logic cannot understand. So they begin to change the content or the word.
有一种说法就是说，其实信耶稣有两个步骤。第一个步骤呢，就是信耶稣做基督徒，然后到了以后，第二个步骤呢，你才做主的门徒，付代价。
And there was one kind of theory or teaching, you know, theology talks about. Okay, there's two steps. The first, you just become a Christian, and then later you become a disciple.
但是问题是圣经没有这样讲。
But this is not what the Bible said.
使徒行传第十一章说，门徒被称为基督徒是从安提亚开始，所以他们起先不叫基督徒，起先都叫门徒。
So you know, actually, in the book of Acts, chapter 11, it says that.You know, they were called the disciples only at church of Antioch. That's when people began to call them Christians.
而且称他们基督徒是取笑他们，就是说 little Christ， 他们像耶稣这样子。
And actually, it was it's the other people call them Christians because they say, oh, these are the little Christ.
所以既然信耶稣是免费的，为什么还要第二阶段？我就问大家。
So I have a question for you. Is that if it is free, then why there is a second step?
就是举例来讲，我送你一部车子，但是经过两年以后呢，我跟你讲说啊，现在开始付我6000块钱。
So for example, I give you an example, okay? So in case, you know, like I gave you a car as a gift, then 2 years later.I came to you and I said, "Okay, now you give me $6,000."
所以有很多的问题，所以是免费的，举手就有，你们只要举手就有。
And many people say, "Well, you just raise your hand, then you receive the eternal life."
那如果我不举手，那我不是傻瓜吗
？And so everybody say, "Oh, that's easy. Okay, I raise my hand."
那另外有一种说法呢，就是说用预定论来讲，就是说啊，神爱世人。那个世人呢，就是神所预定要得救的人。
And then another theology talk about, oh, you know, especially
God so loved
the world.
那个是、yes. 这个世界这个字呢，是神预定说要得救的这个人。所以
And they interpret say the world meaning those people that God already predestined that they will be saved.
所以神已经定了，谁要得救，谁不得救，所以跟你没有关系。
So they say, "Well, God already, this is all in God's sovereignty. He already decide who will be saved, who will not. So have nothing to do with your own choice."
所以，但是路加福音这里，耶稣说要跟随他的，要付那么大的代价，那到底是谁的呀
？And here in the book of Luke, Jesus talk about if you truly want to follow me, you have to pay a big price. So who is correct?
所以大家有答案吗？
Do you have answers?
耶稣说凡是接待圣经说凡是接待他的就是信他名的他就赐权柄做上帝的儿女
Because Jesus actually said that if you receive me and to believe in my name and I will receive you as my sons and daughters
所以接待耶稣才是就是信耶稣信耶稣不是头脑的是接待耶稣欢迎他进来你心里头
So, to believe, actually, you have to receive him and to believe in him.
所以我这个问题以前搅扰很多，所以我常常问很多牧师，我说那圣经怎么解释啊？这个啊穿礼服啊，还有不穿礼服的那些，哎呀，怎么解释我都不会。
In the past, I was kind of confused about these issues, and I asked many pastors.
所以 每一个人牧师回答就说，那看他是怎么信哦，信是怎么信呢？
And so the most pastors tell me, well, it depends on when they receive and when they believe, what kind of attitude, you know, that they believe.
啊，你们知道那个雅各书有一句话说，鬼魔也什么？
信，确实在。
鬼魔也信，确实占尽。
The book of James, there's a verse talk about even the devil believe, but they tremble.
所以看什么样子的信。
So it depends on how, what kind of the substance of your faith and how you believe.
信如果只是一个概念的话，那不算信。
If you only have a concept, you say, oh yeah, I know who he is and I did pray, that is not.
信是一个接待。
So if you believe, you have to receive.
然后跟神建立关系。
And you have to establish a relationship with him, a personal relationship.
所以启示录也说，我在叩门，然后听见我声音开门的，我就进来与他一同坐席。
So in the book of Revelation, it talks about God was knocking at the door, and we need to open the door to inviting him into us.
所以耶稣呼召人来到他面前是要做门徒的。
When Jesus called people, he called them to be disciples.
所以你看最后一个行就是说，就是背十字架，然后做我的门徒。
And therefore, the last phrase says, "You have to carry the cross and follow me; otherwise, you cannot be my disciple."
所以这个信呢，是老师跟学生的关系，是父亲跟儿子的关系。
So this belief is like a relation between a teacher and a student, and a father and a son.
这个信不是说喝一杯 juice 啊，或是吃一块面包这种信。
And it's not like, oh, I just drink this juice or eat a bread, then I have it.
请问耶稣圣餐的里头，法利赛人有没有在里头跟耶稣圣餐
？Let me ask you, did the Pharisee also partake in the communion?
有吗？没有。
I don't think.
只有耶稣的门徒。
Only the disciple.
那我们是不是门徒啊
？Are we his disciple?
如果我们不是门徒，只是一个概念，那不行。
If we only have a concept of him and not true disciple, then that's.
我们刚刚唱歌的时候讲说，他 Jesus Jesus， 你是最宝贵的。那我承认神的宝贵，然后。我跟他建立那样的关系就可以。
And when we sing the songs, we say Jesus, you say you are the most precious, and we have this relationship with you.
啊，我举一个例子，我刚刚突然想到，我有一次啊去纽约去我书法老师的家。
I'll give you an example. Once I visit my calligraphy teacher in New York.
他的客厅呢有一张字，四个大字，写的非常高。
And there was there's a calligraphy there, and it was four character, and it was well written.
我说张老师，这个字是谁写的？可不可以送我啊
？So I asked him. I said, "Who wrote this? This is marvelous. Can I have it?"
那个张老师说，你眼光很好啊。
He said, "You got good."Good taste.
这是 David 周写的。
This is my best student David that wrote this.
他告诉我说，看得懂的才送他。
And he told me you can only give to who will appreciate it.
我那天一看就看懂。
And that day when I saw it, I immediately recognized this is very good.
所以他就送我了。
So I got it.
而那个 David 周呢，是现在我的老师。
And David is now currently is my teacher.
你知道耶稣怎么讲？耶稣说那个珍珠不要丢给猪吃啊。
And Jesus said, "Do not throw the pearl to the pigs."
你如果懂主耶稣基督的价值的话，你就会愿意摆下一切来跟随他。这是门徒，这是真正信。
And if you truly understand the value.Of Jesus, then you will lay down, you know, a lot of things just to honor him.
罗马书第十章说，口里认耶稣是什么？
And、
你们如果心里
10,
心里信神叫他从死里复活，口里认耶稣是谁？
主
是 Lord 是主。
And so talk about if you confess with your mouth that he is the Lord, and then you believe in your heart that he's a savior.
如果他不是你的主，他就不可能做你的救主。
If he is not your Lord, then he cannot save you. He cannot become your savior.
因为人的罪就是背逆神，离开神。
Because you know the sin of man is because we rebel against God and we departed from God.
所以得救就是我们跟神恢复了关系。
So what it means by being saved is because our relationship with him is being restored.
那么耶稣是 免费的礼物，因为神用这么大的礼物把他的神儿子赐给你跟我，然后我们知道他的价值，所以我们接受他。So
because God gave us the biggest gift of His Son, and so you know, and we recognize the value, so we accept Him.
这个 free gift 这个是免费的礼物呢，是耶稣基督。 不是上帝给你一个小玩意儿，装在你口袋里的东西。And
this free gift is Jesus Himself. It's not like a toy or something small. You just put it in your pocket.
如果说我们信耶稣不需要付任何的代价，然后就快快就是像上天堂这样子，这不是主耶稣的教导。And
if you think just believe in Christ is just, oh, I accept him and then I live happily, then one day I go to heaven. That's not what Jesus was teaching.
很多经文啊，像腓立比书第二章也是这样讲说，天上无不向他屈膝口称耶稣是主。
And many verses talk about the attitude. Like in Philippians, talk about every, you know, all creation will kneel before him and call him the Lord.
所以进入得救的关系，就是你不是说啊，我只是口里承认，是跟神建立那个关系就会得救。So
how can you be saved? It's not just by saying it. You have to establish the relationship with the Father and with Jesus.
请问你能用这种态度来信吗？来接受吗
？Can you accept him with this kind of attitude?
行吗
？Can you? Yes.
然后你会在跟随他的当中呢，你越来越成为门徒。Then
as you follow him, then you find yourself really developing and becoming his true disciple.
因为你越跟他的话，你会越认识他的价值，然后你越他兴旺，你越衰微，然后你越跟从他。So
because you know, as you follow him, more and more you discover how precious he is, how valuable it is, and therefore his life will increase, be manifest, and your old life will diminish.
而且神呢，给我们每一个人都有机会。
And God gave every single one of us the opportunity.
大家记不记得那个最后一个时辰进葡萄园的那个比方呢？
Do you still remember the
11th hour?
Yeah, the 11th hour about the vineyard, the workers that went into the vineyard the last hours.
感谢主啊！我到了生命的已经很尽头，我才突然明白说，哇，原来他是这个宝贝。 我进到葡萄园里头，我得的奖赏跟第一个进来的一样的奖赏，上帝就给我这个恩典跟机会。And
I realized in my old age, you know, how precious this is, and you know, so I consider myself very fortunate at the last hours able to enter into the vineyard.
所以啊，我已经信主信了好几十年了，到现在才越来越知道他是宝贝。And
I've been a Christian for all these years, but you know, till recently, I treasure him more and more.
所以弟兄姊妹，主耶稣讲的话是很重的。You
know, brother, sister, his word may be very strong and heavy.
但是你不要担心。But
don't worry.
因为这样子的认识其实也是成长的过程。This
is a growing process to know him.
我35岁的时候就做牧师了。
And when I was 35, I was a pastor already.
我已经在教堂讲道。
I was preaching in the church.
每一次讲完道，师母就问我说：“你今天在讲什么啊？”
Usually I will ask him, "What did you talk about today?"
你又讲这样也可以，那样也可以。
It seems to don't, you know, it can be this way or that way. What is the?
但是现在啊，对神越来越认识了。
Now I know him more and more.
所以弟兄姊妹，没关系的，你现在不是很认识，但是你只要心对的话。上帝圣灵会教导你的，然后有一天 你会绝对的做他的门徒，顺服他的。
So don't worry, because you know, just continue grow, continue wanting to know him, then you know you will find yourself becoming a true disciple.
所以我讲的就是说啊，我们得救不只是一个口号。
Therefore, I just want to tell you that salvation is not a slogan.
也不是一个概念。
It's not a concept.
而是跟神建立那个关系。
But to establish a personal relationship with him.
他呼召你，你就跟随他。
He call you and you follow him.
然后当你跟随的时候，你会越来越认识他。
As you follow him, you will get to know him more and more.
然后他会越来越成为你的第一位。
And then he will become more and more. He become the number one in your life.
别人你会继续爱
，and you will continue to love people too.
但是奇妙的是，他会变第一个是你最爱的，然后其他人会变第二个你所爱的。
And the amazing thing is that, you know, slowly you found that he is the one that you love the most, but you still love other people.
但是弟兄姊妹，你放心，你，我刚信耶稣的时候，我太太觉得有第三者介入，哇！他很嫉妒的。
Don't worry. When I first accept Christ, my wife, my girlfriend at the time, thinking I was having, we were having a third person, a third party in our relationship, and I was jealous. She was jealous.
但是你会发觉，当你越爱耶稣的时候呢，你会越爱你的太太或是你的丈夫。
But you'll find out that if you love him more and more, then you can love your spouse more and more.
你绝对的爱耶稣的话，你会很完更完全的爱你所爱的人。
If you truly love him more, then you'll find that you can love other people too.
If you love God absolutely, then you can love your loved ones perfectly.Amen.
Amen.
因为这是神的心意，所以你放心，你把神摆在第一位的话，哇，你的太太、你的丈夫呢，他日子就好过了。
Just don't worry. So if you just put him on the first place, then your wife, your family member, they will be blessed.
所以大家读路加福音十四章的时候，你不要太沮丧。吓一跳。
So when you read Luke 14, don't be too worried.
大家可以接受吗？
Can you accept that?
可以吗？ 有谁愿意啊？
Are you willing?
Yes.
因为主说，如果不是这样爱我的话，你不能做我的门徒。
Because Jesus said it clearly, if you don't love me like this way, you cannot be my disciple.
而且我们就在地上用以前一般可能的爱，我们也不会进到很棒的一个地步。
If we just use the sort of human love, you know, you cannot really go too far.
That's right. 最后两句话就是大家所看的这个圣经里头，在第路加福音十四章，耶稣做两个比方，我这个提过去就好了。
Okay, the last
28节开始。
Yeah, on 20, verse 28, Jesus gave them two parables.
一个是什么？
One is about building a tower.
就是盖房子。一个就是出兵打仗。
And the other one is about having a war.
这两个都不容易的。
This is all challenging.
都需要勇敢，都需要信心的。
You need faith, you need to be very brave.
所以意思就是说，做主的门徒的代价呢，是要付代价，是要勇敢去冒险的。
That means if you want to be a true disciple, then You have to pay the price and you are willing to take a risk.
所以很多人跟耶稣的时候，耶稣就转过头来的意思就是说，你如果不敢的话，你就先回去吧。
So many was following him and Jesus turned back and then what he meant is that if you are afraid, you know, then you can go home.
你有没有看过有人跟一半回去了？有。
Have you seen people who follow halfway and then they turn back? Yes.
但是我不愿意，我要一直跟随到底。
But I choose to follow him all the way.
所以这个救恩呢，是那些一直跟随做主的门徒的。
And so salvation is given to those that truly wanting to follow all the way.
所以你说主啊，我愿意，我信心不足，我勇气不足。上帝说：“你只要愿意，人有愿做的心，就蒙悦纳，我就给你恩典，加力量给你。”
So you can be honest to him and say to him, "Father, I'm willing, but I don't have my faith is weak, and sometimes I'm not brave enough." But God said, "God will tell you that as long as you're willing, then I give you the courage. I will give you the faith."
Amen. 可不可以接受这个挑战
？Can you?Receive this challenge.
高高兴兴的接受路加福音十四章耶稣基督向我们的挑战。
Just gladly accept the challenge that Jesus gave to us according to Luke 14.
我们可不可以唱那个第一首歌那个 I Stand 那个歌
？I stand, yeah, I stand.
Is it possible?
Yeah, yes, we can.
所以啊。我们来唱那个，有没有那个歌词啊？
Grace.
虽然做主的门徒有代价要付
Even though we need to pay the price to be a disciple,
虽然有挑战
even though we may face challenge,
但是我们说主我们愿意
but we say to you, we are willing,
加给我们恩典
give us grace,
所以你的恩典成为我们的力量
therefore your grace become our strength,
使我们成为你要我们成为的人，做你要我们做的事。
To enable us to become who you want us to become, to do what you call us to do.
谢谢主。
Be thankful.
谢谢主你的爱。
Thank you for your love.
谢谢主你的无条件免费的恩典。
And thank you for this unconditional grace.
奉主耶稣基督的圣名。
In Jesus' name.